Hello. It is I, the person with no name. Welcome. In this video, we will be discussing the Netflix show Maid. Now, when I first saw this show, I wasn't going to talk about it or do a commentary because it's a pretty harsh topic to talk about, and I am highly inexperienced with the goings-on in this film. I repeat, I am highly inexperienced with the goings-on in this film. Okay, for anyone who tries to come for me, don't. Thanks very much. Appreciate it. But I decided to talk a little bit about this show because I feel like no one's talking about it. So here are the topics I will be discussing: the storyline, the educational part, the editing, the likes and dislikes, and the characters, obviously. Pretty plain and simple. Moving on. Usually I will give you a description, and then I give you the shorter description that is well written and, you know, just shorter. Maid is about a young mom named Alex who has been abused by her ex-boyfriend. She leaves that abusive state along with her daughter, Maddie, and tries to take care of her daughter as well as herself, and goes through some complications down the way. Oh, and also she's a maid. Imagine if she wasn't. In the show, she's called Maid because... Anyway. Okay, better description. Here it is. Don't feel like reading it. Next, editing. This mostly leans towards the money that kept popping up on the screen. I watched a sneak peek before the show was released, so it wasn't surprising, but it was creative.
Do you want to call the cops now? It's not too late. And say what? That he didn't hit me?
Which makes us switch to the educational part. Like I said before, I have not experienced what Alex has, and learning about the struggles she went through was quite educational, to say the least. This story was a memoir of the creator of the show. In this show, we learn a lot about a lifestyle that some of us have never really encountered on. And that's all I have.
Well, I'm working on it.
And you've been out all day biking.
So
Maddie's just been stuck with your mom sitting on the couch watching Jeopardy?
No. They watch Wheel of Fortune.
Oh, this is funny to you.
Thanks.
You have a rage problem and you have a drinking problem, and you shouldn't have custody of our kid if you're going to let your mommy do it for you.
Now moving on to the likes and dislikes of the show, which will also tie in with the characters. My biggest dislike is that many people aren't talking about the show, and I don't know why. My next dislike is the boyfriend, whose name is Sean, playing this game of, I want to take care of my daughter, to, I'm just a mess, you deal with her. We see this in the beginning, and spoiler alert, in the end. Other than her daughter, every character seems to have a purpose and plays an important role in Alex's life for the better or for worse.
No, I never should have left.
Yes, you should have.
He's a great dad, and Maddie adores him, and they're home right now, and they're snuggling together, and I'm alone in a shelter that I don't belong in.
You're here because he abused you.
He didn't abuse me. He punched a wall beside my head, and I didn't do anything about it, and I didn't file a police report, and I didn't call the cops.
Fuck the police report. Punching a wall next to you is emotional abuse. Before they bite, they bark. Before they hit you, they hit near you. Next time it was going to be your face, and you know that.
For example, the girl that we met at the... I don't remember her name, but I'm just going to put her picture here. I wish we saw more of this character, but that's life. Sometimes we meet someone for only a short period of time that can make a huge impact on us. The mother. There was a moment where she no longer annoyed me. I actually felt sorry for her, which was during the rehab scene, but I thought she would allow her daughter to explore on her own and go to the college that she wanted to go to and etc. But it seems at the end of the day, they may need each other. Now, people who I don't have much to say about, but still needs a spotlight, is the father of Alex. I don't have much to say. He seems like a good guy trying to get his life or getting to get his daughter back. The lady, Regina, obviously wasn't the best person. We probably would have already known. We already know that before she even spoke, the fact that her name was Regina, like, we get it. But she's your average rich lady who doesn't have time to care about anyone else because she has problems of her own, but develops a character growth and opens her eyes and ears to people around her, i.e. Alex. The one lady, I don't remember her name either, and if I find it on Google, I'll put it here. I wasn't against her firing Alex for the most part. She was alright to me. The friends of the couple should really just stay out of their friends' relationship business. Just saying. I didn't see Alex and Sean getting into their situations. The BF needs to get his life together. Obviously, he's an addict, which isn't an easy thing to let go. It takes time, but he still needs to get his life together. Definitely deserves someone who cares about him the same or more than how he cares about Nate. Overall, he's a real troop, whether he let Alex and Maddie stay over because he liked her or he was just being nice. I think this is a show everyone should go and watch. It's a series and has 10 episodes. It's not that long in the year of 2021. And you can watch it on Netflix, obviously. Okay, that is all. I just wanted to make this short. I hope you enjoy. If you have watched the show and want to voice your own opinion about it, that's what the comment section is for. So use it, okay? Thank you for watching and / listening to my film talk.
We don't have anywhere to sleep tonight. With the fire that you started in.